today I'm going to be doing a review of My Best Friend's Exorcism by Grady Hendrix. I read this book at about the end of 2016. It's not one that's discussed on BookTube a lot, so I figured that I would do a little review for it. I really, really enjoyed this book. I know Grady Hendrix's other book, Horror Store, was really popular on BookTube around the time that came out. That book is about like a haunted IKEA, and I know that one's whole allure was that it looked like an IKEA catalog. This one kind of has the same thing. I really like the way that Grady Hendrix formats his books. One is formatted to look like a yearbook from the 1980s. This is a YA horror novel. I was very pleasantly surprised by it. So it follows our main characters Gretchen and Abby, who have been best friends since 1982 in their small town of South Carolina. Gretchen and Abby have been best friends since the fourth grade. They are still friends throughout high school. They're still best friends, but then an unfortunate skinny dipping incident occurs and Gretchen starts to act up a little bit. Things are very different with her, and she is not the same Gretchen that Abby has known throughout most of her life, and she comes to the conclusion that Gretchen is possessed by a demon. It's all about that, and it's all about friendship, and if friendship is strong enough to beat these inner demons that Gretchen has. Literally, I really enjoyed this book. I think I gave it 3.5 out of 5 stars on Goodreads. I'll link my Goodreads review in the description as well. This book is like every cheesy 80s movie that I've ever loved meets exorcism movies, and I really enjoyed that. I really enjoyed the fact that every single chapter has the title of an 80s song. I couldn't help but to make a playlist out of all the songs that were the chapter headers of this book and listen to that playlist while I was reading this book. I love anything 1980s. I don't want to say I'm one of those people that feels like I was born in the wrong generation, but man, if I could pick an era to live in, it would most certainly be the 1980s. I love 80s movies, I love 80s music, I love it. I love it oh so much. You saw my little Cyndi Lauper dance-a-rama at the is that what I'm gonna call it? I guess. I will say my biggest gripe about this is that I feel like it did get wrapped up a little too perfectly and a little too quickly. I feel like the beginning of this book was very slow and a lot of build-up, which I really enjoy. I like build-up, especially in horror novels. I feel like once the climax came to a head and our conflict was resolved, I feel like this wrapped up a little too fast and a little too kitschy, and I think that is something that kept me from really bumping the rating of this up. But other than that, I think this was a very enjoyable read. There's not much I can go into detail with this book without spoiling like major moments in the book, so I am going to have a spoilery section to talk about all of my feelings. But if you are a fan of horror novels, if you like exorcism stories, if you're a big 1980s junkie, I would definitely suggest you pick up My Best Friend's Exorcism. It's not the most riveting piece of literature I've ever read, but it was extremely enjoyable and I'm very glad that I did pick it up. If you're really into books with really cool formatting, I would look at this one because it is formatted to look like a yearbook. The end papers have like signatures and it looks like a little high school yearbook, and I think that is a really cool touch that this book has. I would highly recommend you make a playlist out of all the songs that are the chapter headers. I think that that makes the reading experience so much fun. I think that that is a really cool thing to do. I would recommend this to anyone who's a fan of horror. If you read Grady Hendrix's other book, Horror Store, and you want to read his other work, give this a try. That's all I can say without really getting into like the nitty-gritty spoilery stuff. So, spoilers! Let's talk about the nitty-gritty of this book, because I have some feelings about it. I think that the way that they handled the actual possession and Gretchen's chains of character was perfect. I really think that Grady Hendrix made this seem like a believable possession story, if that makes sense. I like that it didn't seem like Gretchen just changed overnight. I like that it was a gradual build up into Abby realizing that she was possessed. I'm glad it wasn't just Gretchen started acting weird one day and Abby's like, well, the devil's behind it. I'm very glad that that wasn't how it goes. I've read a lot of stories and I've seen a lot of stories revolving around exorcisms where a girl just says one mean thing and the main character's like, well, guess gotta call an exorcist. It's like, why is that the first thing that you go to? I really like how Gretchen was like slowly sabotaging all of these people, and I think that some of the moments were just so like, it made my skin crawl. Scene with Margaret and the worm, and you realize that those smoothies that she'd been drinking, or I think they're milkshakes or they're smoothies, I can't remember off the top of my head, but that they're like tapeworms was just so skin crawling. There was so much in this book that was just so like vile, I guess. What was that scene with Glee in the bell tower? I feel like once we got into the thick of the actual possession and when things really started to come to a head up until the exorcism, I feel like everything was just so rushed and just too fast paced compared to the rest of the book, which I wasn't really the biggest fan of. I think this book could have easily been an extra 50 pages. I wouldn't have had a single complaint about it. But I will say that I think that the scenes involving the actual exorcism itself were wonderfully done. It was creepy, it was heart-wrenching, it was very worrisome, it had me anxious. Like, I was sitting there like, oh my god, what's gonna happen? And it was incredible. I will say I think it was a bit corny that the whole, like, overarching theme was like friendship saves all, and just the way that they did it, like the way that they finished out the exorcism with Abby like singing songs where she's like, by the power of Phil Collins, I rebuke you. It's like, really? Like, that was a part where I kind of cringed a little bit, and I thought that was a bit corny. I understand why it was done. Like, she was bringing back all these things that they loved together to like rebuke this demon, and to say that Gretchen was still there, which I appreciated. I love some cheese and some corniness, but that was a bit much for me. But it still like made me cry. I think that this book was well executed. I think that it was a bit rushed towards the end, and the way that they like grew old together in like 30 pages, not even 30, it was like 5 pages. Is like, oh, they grow all together and they died, everything is happy. I wish it was tied up in a different way than that, but I don't really have any major complaints about this book. It was enjoyable. Not like the most outstanding piece of literature that I've ever read, but I don't really expect that going into horror novels. So, you know, I was expecting something fun, lighthearted, super 80s. I loved that. I loved the aesthetic that this book gave off. Really, really liked this one. So, yeah, yup. So you guys, there you have it. That is my review of My Best Friend's Exorcism by Grady Hendrix. I hope you enjoyed this review. I'm trying to get more reviews up on this channel. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, leave some comments on your thoughts on this book if you've read it, and if you haven't, like, give it a try maybe. If you want to see more of my content, you can always subscribe. I upload every Monday and Wednesday. Like I said, my name is Morgan. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, and happy reading. Okay, bye! Thank you.